Hi, welcome to Programming with Nash. In this session, we want to work with the device's camera with hooks and use it to save an image in the desired location. In the previous session, we learned how to use the Google Maps service in the app and show different locations on the map. In this session, we want to access the phone's camera using the React Native Camera module and take a photo using it. Through this link, we follow how to install and configure the module. First, we use this command to install the module. Now, in order to fulfill its requirements in Android, we add these permissions in this pass in the Android manifest file. Then, in the build.gradle file in the app folder in the default config section, we add this line. We also add this line, so that you don't get a multidex error when you sync the Gradle. Now, to be able to use this module in a functional component, we use the React Native Camera Hooks module. From this section, using this command, we install the module. We also use the React Native FS module to be able to work with saved image files and move them to our desired location. Using this command, we also install this module. Now go to the Android folder and sync the Gradle. Now let's go back to the project folder and run the app. Now create a button on the home screen to move to the camera screen by pressing it. To do this, we use the custom button component that we created earlier. Inside the onPress function, we use the navigation props to navigate to the camera screen. Well, the button was created correctly. Now we create the camera screen. We are currently create a simple page. And import it in app.js file to add it in Stack Navigator. Well, as you can see, we enter the camera screen by pressing the button. Now we want to have a preview of the phone camera on this page. First, on the camera page, we import the RM camera component. Then we import the use camera to use the hooks. Here we will use two camera ref and take picture hooks. Well, now we use the RM camera component. For ref, we use the camera ref hook. The type can be front or back camera, which we choose back here. Now we define a style for it. So that it covers the whole screen and its child components are arranged from the bottom and center. Now inside the camera component, we define a button that we can use to capture the image. I create a function called CaptureHandle to store the image inside. Here I use the try-catch block to display inside the console if an error occurs. I create a const called data to use takePicture hook to insert image data. Here I use async await so that after saving the image, we can see the saved address in the console. Well, I refresh the app and enter the camera screen. The custom component is not imported here, which I do. Well, now we come back to the camera screen. This time we are asked for the permissions we defined in Android manifest that we allow. Because we use the emulator, a 3D environment is displayed as a camera preview. In this environment, we can move like a first-person game by moving the mouse and WASD keys while holding down the Alt key. Well, now we choose a subject. For example, we take a picture of this dog. In this case, we need to see the address of the image stored in the console. And as you can see, the image is saved at this address. But in general, we don't have access to this location, and we can't access the photo file. So using the React Native FS module, we want to move the saved image file to the place we have access to. To do this, use the moveFile method. And first we enter the source address, and then the destination address. The source address here is the address where the captured image is stored. And I consider the destination address as one of the default addresses of this module, which is actually inside the data app folder. Now we can add the desired name for the photo to the end of this address. Here, after the transfer is complete, I want to display both addresses in the console. And if an error occurs during the transfer, I will show it in the console. Now I take another photo and we see the result in the console. Well, I choose another subject. For example, the kitchen environment. As you can see, after capturing the image file is transferred from this address to this address. Now go to the phone file manager to find the image file. Well, the image is stored correctly in this path with our desired name. Now if I take another picture, because I didn't rename the file, the new image replaces the previous image by default. So there we go. We learned how to use the device's camera to save the captured image in the desired location. So in the next video, we will talk about testing in React Native. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next session.